thought you were those nosy producers. Well, take a good look, Missy, because this is the last time you're going to see me in this box office. For years, my obvious talents have been overlooked in favor of that no-talent douchebag Gail Wilson. Well, no more! Tonight, a new star rises in the firmament. My destiny calls!
I had a dream!
Ethel?
A dream about you, baby!
You did, Ethel?
It's gonna come true, baby!
It is?
They think that we're through!
They do?
God, baby!
Yes?
You
will be! Oh, I will!
You'll be great!
Oh, I know!
Gonna have the whole world on a plate!
When?
Start to hear!
Oh, that soon?
Now!
Oh, boy! Everything's coming up, Peckerhead! Fasten your seatbelts. It's going to be a bumpy night! Oh.
Give 'em the old razzle dazzle, razzle dazzle 'em. Give 'em an act with lots of flash in it, and the reaction will be passionate. Give 'em the old hocus pocus, bead and feather 'em. How can they see with sequins in their eyes? What if your hinges all are rusting? What if, in fact, you're just disgusting? Razzle dazzle 'em, and they'll never get wise.
Give 'em the old razzle dazzle, razzle dazzle 'em. Back since the days of old Methuselah, everyone loves the big bamboozler. Give 'em the old three-ring circus. When you're in trouble, go into your guests. Stiffer than a girder, they'll let you get away with murder. Razzle dazzle 'em, and you got a
everyone, hold for notes.
Not too shabby. God, that dance break was right on the money. And we even fit teaser on that rain curtain. Great.
Gail, you sound really terrific. And you look so well-dressed, I mean to say. Really dazzling tonight. We'll be running your Connie Francis number in about a half an hour. And then Miss Black Pussy.
Excuse me?
Miss Black Pussy.
It's Pussy. Yolanda Black Pussy.
Black Pussy. I am so sorry. I do apologize.
Please stay close by. We will be running your number after Gail's. That's it.
Okay, everybody, take 10. A 5, 6, 7, 8.
All right, already with that Elvis bit. You're the stage manager, not Elvis. Now manage.
Yeah, but that's a drag. No pun intended. I don't want to watch, I want to be in the show.
And so does everyone else. Now we've got auditions and rehearsals up for you know what, so let's move.
Ahem.
Oh, my. Don't you look lovely today? It's Peckerhead.
Mucho, mucho. Mr. Abramson? Mr. Svetonich?
Yes, Miss Peckerhead. How are things with the box office?
Oh, primo, just primo. One might say S-R-O.
Good, good.
But gentlemen, I know you're very busy, and I hate to interrupt such importante proceedings, but you did promise me a chance to audition for this show.
Oh, but Miss P, nobody works that box like you do.
That box is too small for what I got inside of me. Why, there isn't a stage big enough. Lights bright enough. There she is, boys.
And there she goes, world. When we do Gypsy, we'll call you.
And we are women.
And we've been behind bars.
And let's discuss this audition business later, please.
Yeah, beat it, sister.
Ladies, I'm afraid you have misunderstood. These auditions are for men behind bars.
Well, then we're men.
Yes, darling, and we have been over, behind, and way under the bar.
Oh, no doubt.
Is that a crack?
Oh, no, ladies, please, let me explain. Men Behind Bars is a bartender's musical variety show, not some B-class prison drama.
Oh, honey, did you say variety show? That's even better, darling, because we are chanteuses.
Oh, what do you chanteuses call yourselves?
What?
The Cream Sisters.
The Cream Sisters?
Yes, of course.
Let's make a deal here. We'll give you an audition if you'll put your guns down. How's that?
Well. Here, darling, you hold on to these. We're going to audition. If they say no, shoot them in the ass. Come on, girl. Are you ready?
Ladies and gentlemen, the Crystal Room is proud to present the club debut of America's new recording stars, the Dreams.
Oh, you sick little moron from hell. How dare you say Dreams? here we are trying to clean for you, and you call us the Dreams, which is a tacky Broadway show. I beg to differ. I must reiterate. This is my darling, amazing sister, Albaline Cream. And this lovely woman is my joyful sister, Jolene Cream. And I am the highly curvaceous by candlelight, Porcelana Cream. Now will you get it right?
Blackpussy's number.
It's Pussy!
Please see Charles about costumes. He's downstairs.
But honey, You, Mr. Drummer Boy, pa-da-ba-bum-bum, honey. You keep those guns, and as if anybody else in this show sucks, I'll shoot them in the ass. You must shoot them in the ass.
Well, I don't know, but I thought they were pretty good.
You know, it scares me to say that I have to agree with you on that one.
Mr. Abramson, Mr. Svetanich.
Oh, not now, Miss Peckerhead. We're really busy.
But you promised.
Later, Peckerhead.
Gentlemen, I hate to resort to a little friendly persuasion, but I do happen to have in my possession a certain vintage 8mm film. I call it Two Men and a Donkey. And oddly enough, these two men bear a striking resemblance. Need I say more?
No, that's impossible. That film was destroyed when the borough died.
Au contraire! I happen to have the only existing copy. Quite a good one at that. And just think what it would do for your reputations. Do you want to be able to show your face in public? Do you want evil, vicious queens dishing you?
I don't.
Do you want to win another cable car award? Oh my God, not that! Let's get our fannies in gear and let's talk audition.
Oh, looks like we don't have much choice in the matter, does it?
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. I just love this showbiz cooperation.
Mark, see if you can find that film. She's probably got it stashed in the box office.
I'll find it. I'll keep her occupied out here.
God, another cable car award. I can't believe it. Oh.
Miss Peckerhead, what is that?
My pickup band.
That much is obvious. Where did you pick it up?
The Estinocha. She's quite popular there, you know. Now, Mommy, now, you stand right here and don't block me.
Bring me the Cobra Jewel.
Shh. Not now, Coyote.
I want the Cobra Jewel.
Put a lid on it. Excuse me, but it's the only English she knows. Now, Mommy, tu juega la acordeona. Comprende?
Si.
Oh, my God. I shall perform Lady of Spain.
That's what you think, Queen.
Slap the baby with something pink. Uno, dos, uno, do, three. Lady of Spain, I adore you. Right from the night I first saw you, my heart has been yearning for you. What else could any heart do?
You got it, kid.
Lady of Spain, I'm appealing. Why should my lips be concealing all that my heart is revealing? Lady of Spain, I love you. Ole, lady.
Thank you, Miss Peckerhead.
What do you mean?
Mark, did you find that film?
Yeah, it was in the box office. God, I really miss that donkey sometimes.
Will you? Miss Peckerhead, thank you for your enthusiasm. Miss Momi, I think it is, the accordionist. We could use you in the show.
Oh, thank you very
much. Would
you
please see us backstage?
You mean you're taking her instead of me? You assassin! Oh!
I thought you were wonderful, Miss Peckerhead.
Oh, shut up! I'm sorry, Vito. It's just that they won't give me a chance. I'm the prisoner of that box office.
Why, I know exactly what you mean, Miss Peckerhead. Well, I could blow them away with my Elvis act, but they won't let me. You know what a bitch Vitas can be.
Abramson, too. But you know, Vito, I think I need to be alone for a while.
Sure, sure.
Say, Feeny, I'll never get into the show.
I can get you that audition. I can make you look so pretty. There's nothing to it, really. There's only one condition about this little mission. You truly must believe in the magic spell you weave, and you'll get the part you treasure oh so dearly. Hurry, 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 hurry. Time to work a little magic, and no time to sit and worry. Don't want nothing that's tragic. When you're needed in the show, all systems will be go. No matter where, no matter when, the spell will kick right in, and you'll get the part you treasure oh so dearly.
Woo!
And you'll get the part I treasure oh so dearly. A dream is a wish your heart makes when you're fast asleep.
This is the 80s. I take it you're supposed to be my fairy godmother?
You got it, honey.
Oh, well then, work a little magic on this.
A skeptic. You know, there's always one in the bunch.
Baby, you want a new ring?
Will that do, honey?
Oh, oh, I do believe in fairy godmothers. I do believe in fairy godmothers.
That's better. But getting into the show is going to take a major dose of magic. Are you sure you're up for it?
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Are you sure you're sure?
Yes, yes.
Are you absolutely sure?
Yes!
All right. But I got to warn you. These spells, well, they've got a mind of their own. There's no way of predicting for sure what'll happen. Once I say the magic words, you're on your own, honey.
Oh, I can see my name in lights now. Come on, fairy godmother, lay it on me.
Salagadula, Michigabula, bibbidi bobbidi boo. Put them together and what have you got? Bibbidi bobbidi boo. Now salagadula, Michigabula, bibbidi bobbidi boo. It'll work magic, believe it or not. Bibbidi bobbidi boo. Now salagadula means a michigabularoo, but the thingamabob that does the job is bibbidi bobbidi boo. Oh, salagadula, michigabula, bibbidi bobbidi boo. Put them together and what have you got? Bibbidi bobbidi, bibbidi bobbidi, bibbidi bobbidi boo. Now salagadula means
a michigabularoo,
but the thingamabob
that does the job
is bibbidi
bobbidi.
Together and what have you got?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our good friend, Danny Williams.
Hi. So did you have a good President's Day?
Yes.
How about in the balcony?
Yes.
They're partying up there. That's good. I'm a little fuzzy. Anyway, last weekend, my lover went out of town. He came to me and said, Danny, I'm going to be out of town for 3 days. And I thought, all right, now I'll get laid. And no, because we've already had sex for the 6 months. It was on January 3rd. It was during Wheel of Fortune. He got excited by Vanna's new outfit. And the next thing I knew, I was standing over him going, big money, big money. Yeah, great. I ended up with a ceramic Dalmatian and lose a turn, so. So here was my big chance. I'm gonna go out to the bars, hit those bars, and experience what it was like to be single again. So I went to the bar to experience what it was like to be single again, and I went home alone, and and decided to enter the exciting new world of telephone sexuality. I mean, there are so many ways to do it now. It's amazing. I mean, this one ad I saw in the paper was advertising S&M phone sex. S&M phone sex. What is that? They force you to take collect calls? Yes, you will accept charges. No, 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 no. Maybe I'm missing something, but I think S&M works a little better if you're both in the same house, you know? Now go to your closet and lick your boots. Can you hold, master? It just, you know. Misses a little something, doesn't it, somehow? And then there's this thing called the connector. It's so cool. What it is you pay these people money, they give you a phone number, you dial it, it connects you to another guy, and you both talk on the phone and choke the chicken. Or in my case, throttle the turkey. I can't help it. So I thought I'd try it. I talked to a friend of mine who uses it all the time, and Mark Abramson said what he does is he gets his voice real masculine and sexy, takes about 3 hours, and he says, hi, what are you wearing? That sounded pretty good. I thought I'd try it. I called up and said, hi, what are you wearing? Queen talked about his clothes for 45 minutes. My luck, I get Jim Spetanich on the first call, but, and all these 976 lines, they are so tasteful. 976 buns, 976 hump, 976 suck. But they're only 1 minute long. I mean, you have to time your passion correctly to make any use of this phone call, you know? Oh, baby, 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 quick dial. Ah! And the worst thing is you get your phone bill and there it is. Buns, buns, suck, suck, hump, hump, hump. Now, I feel pretty stupid calling the phone company and saying, there's too many buns on my bill. Can you fix that, please? You won't fix it. Oh, no, the S&M phone operator. No, 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 no. Thank you very much. You're just swell. Now, since I had the weekend, I went to a second bar. Why not? My favorite bar, second night out. There they are. They're having a contest for a title. No problem. I went to another bar. They're having a contest for a title. That's okay. I'll go to a third bar. They're having a contest for a title. Every bar in town is having a contest for a title. After streets or neighborhoods or the bar or body parts, Mr. Thymus Gland, you know? So I realized the only thing we can do is sort of have the ultimate title, the ultimate contest. Please join me tonight in the search for Mr. Center of the Universe. Hmm. Now, what we have done is we have searched the United States for the only 20 gay men in the country who do not have a title. I am now going to announce the names of the three finalists. As I call your name, I will read from the card that you completed when you entered the contest. Our first contestant, Max Cumload.
All right.
Max has entered and lost Mr. San Francisco Leather, Mr. Drummer, International Mr. Leather, and International Ms. Leather. His hobby, collecting trucks. All right. His favorite fetish, having his head put into a vise. Oh, somebody who likes that. You should call them later. Now, his occupation, poodle trimmer. Down boy. Okay, now, our second finalist from West Hollywood, Binky St. Marie. Binky is the only man ever to be deported by West Hollywood. His hobby, quote, I have the largest thimble collection in North America, unquote. Somebody's seen it. His favorite fetish, quote, ooh, gross, I hate that kinky stuff. All I need is a man, a rocking chair, some potato salad, and a spatula, and I'm ready. His occupation, truck driver. Must be for Bonnie Hubbard. Now, our third finalist, he just came out 2 hours ago, and we found him outside the Greyhound bus terminal. Please welcome Gilbert Hernandez. Popular man. Now, according to this card, Gilbert is 6'3", 140 pounds, and 23 years old. Hot chicken here, okay. Now, his hobby is North Dakota. His favorite fetish is yes. His occupation, to finish eighth grade. All right, we wish you luck, Gilbert. Now we come to the final part of our contest. This is the part where you parade before the judges, and remember, be as butch as you can. Don't worry, we have medics on call. I think we've had enough. Okay, let's go back over there. I think this is more than enough. Many of us have eaten dinner. And I believe the judges have reached a decision. May I have the envelope, please, to announce the winner? And the winner, 1988, Mr. Center of the Universe is... Who are you?
Why, I'm Joe Ross.
Oh! Joe Ross is the winner. Joe.
You're a pale-faced, mealy-mouthed simp, and I hate you.
What did you say your name was?
It was Joe Ross.
Bob Ross.
No, Joe. Joe
Bob
Ross, J-O-E.
Bob Ross.
I never can win any of these contests.
Why?
I couldn't get anybody to notice me if I walked down Ringgold Alley, stark naked.
Max, you take this trophy. Just remember these words.
Thanks, Joe.
When you cruise Ringgold Alley, hold your head up high and don't be afraid.
dark. At the end of the street, there's a gorgeous guy, and his name is engraved in your heart. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain with your dreams of being blown.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Connie Francis story. From teenage Constance Francanero to an international singing star, share the joys and frustrations, the agonies and the ecstasies of this teen dream queen's musical years.
Cara mia, Connie, you a girl with the voice of an angel. A girl, you a girl who can sing and cry at the same time. You a girl with a mustache. Oh, Connie, you break my heart.
Oh, Papa, I'm sorry. I'm really, really sorry.
Oh, that's okay, Connie.
I'm so sorry. I'm so very, very
okay,
sorry.
Okay, Connie.
I'm
okay.
So sorry.
Okay,
I'm
you're
so
sorry.
Sorry.
You're sorry.
I'm sorry now. Sorry now, whose heart is aching for breaking each vow? Who's sad and blue? Who's crying too? Just like I cried over you. Right to
that was only the beginning. Watch as Connie meets and marries the man of her dreams.
Oh!
Watch as accordion players play at Connie's big Italian wedding. Watch as the name Connie Francis becomes a household word in every home in Philadelphia. Watch as the dream crumbles.
Oh.
A sadder but wiser Connie learns to convey the bitter lessons of life through her music. In the Connie Francis story, you'll suffer with Connie through such songs as...
There's nothing left for me of days that used to be. I live in memory among my souvenirs, evening shadows make me blue. When each weary day is through, how I long to be with you, my happiness.
It was the revolting 60s, the Beat Generation. Artists were beginning their path down, looking for social consciousness and political awareness. It was a time of questioning authority and re-examining traditional values. Artists were not content to merely entertain. The medium was the message, and everybody had one. Songs began to tackle more mature themes. Connie Francis was not far behind.
Stupid Cupid, you're a real mean guy. I'd like to clip your wings so you can't fly. I'm in love and it's a crying shame. And I know that you're the one to blame. Hey, hey, set me free. Stupid Cupid, stop picking on me. You got me jumping like a crazy clown. And I can't beat you what you're putting down. Seems like you're so low to live to fight. The thing that bothers me is that I'd like it fine. Hey, hey, set me free. Stupid Cupid, stop picking on me. Hey, hey, set me free. Stupid Cupid, stop picking on me.
In the Connie Francis story, you'll witness poignant moments in which she gladly performs for free at the opening of Italian bakeries and pizzerias.
As the lovely evening star, in the kiss that I gave was the love I had saved for a lifetime. Then I knew all of you was completely mine.
So pack up your 45s and be the first on your block to see the Connie Francis story. The story no one knows. The story you've been waiting for. Where the songs are. Where the joys are. Where the tears are.
A smiling face, a warm embrace, two arms to hold me tenderly. Where the boys are, my true love will be. He's walking down some street in town, and I know. Crowd of a million people, I'll find my Valentine. Then I'll climb to the highest steeple and tell the world he's mine. Delia, I'll wait in
the boys are, where the boys are, where the boys are. Someone wait for me. La 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 la. Woo! La 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 la. La 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 la. Hallelujah.
I was a blueprint or something. Oh, you stay out of my way. Keep that miserable fraud away from me. Oh. Oh.
My, but isn't Miss Magenta Head touchy today?
Well, she has every right to be the way you've been carrying on.
What is it now, Miss Peckerhead?
There seems to be a slight problem. Miss Black Pussy?
It is to say!
Whatever! Has been arrested for soliciting.
Oh, no. I told her not to try to sell those ebony subscriptions in Chinatown.
And thrown into jail, would you wake up and smell the coffee?
Oh.
This is just great. We're all set to run her number.
Oh, I'd be happy to take her place.
What the hell's going on now? Yo, Londa, is that you?
Well, it ain't your mama, girlfriend. There is something strange going on around here. One minute, I was in jail, and the next minute, poof, I say poof, here I be.
Well, I don't know what's going on around here, but I do know we've got to run your number.
Come on, honey, let's go.
You know, girls, it's hard to find a guy that really blows your mind. And you just dig everything he does, like when he gives you that great big special hug and that heavy kiss. Girls, you know the kind. The kind that's in the wrong place at the wrong time, and it really turns you on. Well, I had a guy like that. Then that time happens to all of us. We had an argument. And like all, and I mean all us girls, I said some pretty dumb things like get lost. I don't want to see you anymore. But he was cool. He just stood there looking so hurt. And he said, if that's the way you want it. And he split. And I just stood there looking dumb and let that man walk right out of my life. And I've been as evil as a wet hen ever since. I told myself I wasn't gonna sweat it, but I did. Oh, he was inside of me. And my thoughts, my dreams. Every place I went, I saw his face. And my friends, they knew. I know they knew. And then one evening I was standing at the bus stop and I heard a voice behind me say, hi, baby. Oh, I just fell all apart inside because I hadn't heard that voice in such a long time. I turned around and there he was, looking good. Oh, I just can't tell you how good that man looked to me. And as I stood there trying to maintain myself, he asked me if I had a few minutes. I really wanted to tell him that I had a lifetime, but I couldn't blow my cool. We stopped at a cozy little place, and I guess the shock of seeing him made me order a martini because that's something that I've never done before. But I thought I needed something stronger than coffee to hang on. Oh, the music was soft, and the lights were low, and that drink had started going to my head. He hadn't said anything about us, so I knew it was my move, and it had to be now. I couldn't feel my nerve building. I couldn't let him go, not this time. Not this time. So I took his hand, looked him straight into the eye, and I said,
I love you. Never know how much I care. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever. When you hold me tight, fever. In the morning, fever all through the night. Lady Di and old Prince Charlie sat upon their royal thrones. When she saw his royal scepter, Lady Di began to moan, "You give me fever." In the courtyard, fever at the palace gate, fever. In the ballroom, Charlie, you're my head of state. Everybody's got the fever, that is something you all know. Fever isn't such a new thing, fever started long ago. Captain Smith and Pocahontas had a very mad affair. When her daddy tried to kill him, she said, "Daddy, oh, don't you dare, he gives me fever." With his kisses, fever as I live and learn. Fever makes me sizzle, what a lovely way to burn. What a lovely way to burn. What a lovely way to burn. You give me fever, fever, fever. I got steam heat, I got I got steam heat, but I need your love to keep away the cold. I got steam heat, I got steam heat, I got steam heat, but I can't get warm without your hand to hold. The radiator's hissing still, I need your kisses to keep me from freezing each night. I got a hot water bottle, but nothing I got will take the place of you. Holding me tight, I got steam heat, I got steam heat, I got steam heat, but I need your love to keep away the cold.
Woo!
fairy godmother. You keep that goddamn wand away from me.
Well, aren't we the snit?
A snit? There I was, all set to step into that number. Then whammo! Miss Black Crusade gets sprung, and I end up in the huska. Oh, the publicity! La publicity!
I warned you these things can sometimes backfire. Oh. But don't worry, we're not licked yet. We just have to resort to the heavy-duty stuff.
Oh, yeah, and the checks in the mail, right?
Hey, come on, trust me. I have got something for you. Let's see what we have here. I know I've got something here for you. Just a minute. Excuse me? As I was saying before, I was so rudely interrupted. First, let's see if we can get Miss Wilson to use this nice little throat spray. And if that fails to do the trick, we'll go all the way and zap her with my super deluxe Gail Wilson hot voodoo doll. Honey, I'm telling you, the Jerry Colletti doll is so popular, I can't even keep it in stock.
That good, huh? Well, what makes you think that that Wilson broad is gonna let me waltz right up to her and spray her throat? She's not exactly fond of me, you know.
Look, I've got a stage man in the back that owes me a favor or two. Just give him the atomizer and let him deliver it.
You know, sometimes I underestimate you fairies.
Well, honey, you ain't the only one.
What else you got in that bag?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, an inspirational message from Miss Tammy Faye.
A little girl playing, having church with her friends, dreaming of the day she'd sing and broken hearts would mend. A little boy dreaming of how he'd preach God's word. Crowds would come, souls were won, hardened hearts were stirred. Then one day the dreams came true after many trials. Not we pass through many fires. Don't give up, you can make it, was the theme of our lives. And we won't give up, we can make it still, with God on.
Is the life for me. Land spreading out so far and wide. Keep Manhattan, just give me that countryside.
New York is where I'd rather stay. I get allergic smelling hay. I just adore a penthouse view. Darling, I love you, but give me Park Avenue.
The chores.
The spring, I got you.
my ring.
While it listens to the local news, he finds out where the bats are biting while he's plowing up to country blues. Yeah, he was a cowboy and he knew I loved him well. A cowboy's secrets you never tell. No, there's nothing like the loving of a hard-driving cowboy man. He's got a tape deck in his tractor while he's plowing up his daddy's land. He's got more horse sense than I ever seen in any man. And he was a cowboy and he knew I loved him well. A cowboy's secrets you never tell. No, there's nothing like the loving of a hard-driving cowboy man. Mr. Ron Brewer. And all the boys will order up another round. In the summertime, we look forward to the rodeo. Saturday night, we go to town. And all the boys will order up another round. When they ride saddle bars, I can't wait to hear that whistle blow. He's got a tape deck in his tractor. I can hear him when he's coming home. Then he holds me in his rocking chair. Cowboy secrets you never tell. No, there's nothing like the loving of a hard-driving cowboy man. No, there's nothing like the muscle of a hard-driving cowboy man.
You know, Jim, I was watching some of that medley from the back of the house, and it's a lot of fun, but it doesn't make any sense.
Mark, what does make sense in the show?
You've got a point there.
Absolutely.
You guys, there's been a slight mix-up with the ballet number. From what I get, the booking agent thought we were recreating the Valpre number and sent them.
What?
But not to worry, it seems they've also studied dance and now double as the Greater Ukiah Opera and Ballet Company.
Oh, wait.
No.
Those girls weren't, to put it politely, petite.
Edwina's not going to like this one at all.
Not at all.
Will you get any better ideas?
Sabotage! Oh, no.
Oh,
my
sabotage!
What happened?
Sabotage!
sabotage, that's what.
Oh.
I got this gift with an atomizer in it. One spray and bam, the whole dye job shot.
Oh, no.
Wait, Gail, this isn't a perfume. It's a throat spray.
Throat spray? If this did this to my hair, what would it have done to my throat? I can't go on like this.
No. Mark, what are we going to do?
Is there a hairdresser in the house?
Hey, Vino, get Dixon and Nello on. Mark, you see about Edwina. Right. She's your boss. I don't care what it takes. Hey, you guys, the rest of you come with me. We got a dye job to save.
Oh, we did it.
Drat! It never occurred to me that this place would be crawling with hair burners. All right, Missy. Time to play hardball. Hot voodoo, black ass mud, hot voodoo in my blood!
Come on, Dixon. Miss Peckerhead.
Vito. Dixon. Break a leg. Break two legs.
Oh, Dixon, isn't she breathtaking?
I'd say that's one way of describing her. Have you told her how you feel?
Oh, I couldn't. I don't know where I'd find the courage.
Oh, hang in there, my man. You'll find the way. Poor boy. Poor boy. Downhearted and depressed and in a spin. Poor boy. Poor boy. Oh, youth could really do a fellow in. Tonight I feel suave and debonair. Gracefully aging without a care. I'm glad I'm not young anymore. The fountain of youth is dull as paint. Methuselah is my patron saint. I'm glad that I'm not young anymore. No more confusion. No morning after surprise, no self-delusion, that when you're telling those lies, he isn't wise. Too old for a wedding day in June, but not for a weekend honeymoon. What better life could heaven have in store? Oh, I'm so glad that I'm not young.
Hello, Dixon.
Why, I can't believe it.
It's been a long, long time.
Yes, it has, Nello. Am I interrupting anything?
No, I'm out on my own today.
Likewise. May I?
Oh, please.
Thank you. After all these years, you know, we were quite an item way back then, weren't we? So much so, I actually want to suggest that we live together.
No kidding.
No, me, the man who swore he'd never get involved in a relationship with a lover. But losing my independence scared the hell out of me, Nello, and I panicked.
Dixon. That's one of the most charming, one of the most enduring excuses I've ever heard.
But I've never forgotten you, Nello. Nor the last evening we spent together. I can remember it just as if it were yesterday. We met at 9.
We met at 8.
I was on time.
No, you were late.
I remember well. We dined with friends.
We dined alone.
A tenor sang.
A baritone.
Ah, yes. I remember it well. That dazzling April moon.
There was none that night. And the month was June.
That's right. That's right.
It warms my heart to know that you remember still the way you do.
Ah, yes.
I remember it well. How often I thought of that Friday,
Monday
night, when we had our last rendezvous. And somehow I foolishly wondered if you might, by some chance, be thinking of it too. That taxi ride,
you walked me home.
You lost your watch.
I lost my comb.
Yes, I remember it well. The show was dull.
It was all the rage.
At the Black Cat?
The Gilded Cage.
Yes, I remember it well. You were not shy but bold.
That is quite untrue.
Am I getting old?
Oh, no. Not you. How strong you were. How young and gay. A prince of love in every way.
Yes. I remember it well.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lacey Keed is an atmospheric poem. It physically incarnates a poetic vision, inspiring a yearning for ideal beauty, which seems momentarily attainable, and then sadly lost.
Probably due to overeating.
Well, anyway. We now proudly present Madame Edwina in the Greater Ukiah Opera and Ballet in Lacey Keed.
Thank you.
we have got is the finale, and we are home free.
Oh, I know, and thank God, because I need a cocktail.
You and me both.
Mr. Abramson, Mr. Svetanich.
Oh, what is it now, Miss Peckerhead?
We've got good news and bad news. The good news, if you can call it that, is Gail's hair is magenta again.
Oh, good.
The bad news is she can't sing the finale. It seems she's developed a severe stabbing pain in her throat. Psychosomatic, if you ask me.
I can't stand it. I just can't stand it. I wanted to stop after three, but no, you wanted to do four. Now what do we do? Well, we just have to buy some time. That's all there is to it. I know. Miss Peckerhead.
Oh, no.
Darling, you wanted to be in this show, didn't you? Here's your big chance.
Let's go get a drink.
You can do it. You can do it. Now you've gotten what you wished for. Honey, you're the star. Stay calm. Whatever you do, just don't get all shook.
Well, bless my soul, what's wrong with me? My stomach is turning and I gotta pee. Who'd have thought I'm gonna have such luck? I'm the star. I'm all shook up. Ooh. Ooh, yeah. Well, my hands are shaking and my knees are weak. I can't seem to stand on my own two feet. Now I'm the lead and Gail's all washed up. I'm the star. I'm all shook up. Ooh, ooh, yeah. Oh, please don't ask me what's on my mind. I'm a little mixed up, but I'm feeling fine. When I get a role
that I love best, my heart beats so it scares me to death. And when she looks at me, you want a thrill I've got. Her lips are like a volcano that's hot. Now listen real close to what I say. I'm in love.
Woo!
With Peckerhead.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My tongue gets tied when I try to speak. My inside shaped like a leaf on a tree.
There's only one cure for this body of mine, and that's to have that girl that I love so fine. When she touches my hand, what a thrill I've got. Her lips are like a volcano that's hot. I'm proud to say that she's my buttercup. We're in love, yeah, and all shook up. Ooh, ooh. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ooh, ooh, yeah, yeah. We're all shook up.
Oh, Vito, take me.
Found this charming little doll in the box office with your hatpin in its throat. I don't suppose you'd know anything about it, would you?
Whatever gave you that impression?
Obviously the work of a rank amateur. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a man waiting for me. Come, Vito.
Talk to you for a minute.
Got some time for me, mister?
Oi, senor, hablas
español? Hey, Tiger, you want to dance? A little dance won't hurt you.
Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir?
Hey, cowboy, I got something for you.
Mushy, mushy, ¿cómo estás?
Ooh, he's got balls!
Let's have some fun!
I'm
Every Follies muscle man is here. Everyone who should be here is here. What a smashing, positively dashing evening at the Sultry Club, Baghdad. Throbbing pecs and bulging biceps overstimulate me just a tad. What a gripping, absolutely ripping evening at the Steamy Club, Baghdad. Pulses rushing, faces flushing, heartbeats speed up. I have never been so keyed up. Any second now, they'll begin to pump. Wait, my pulse is beating, I am breathing harder. Woof. I think I've come. Oh, that was a good one. What a frenzied moment that was. I'm sure I gave it all I had. 'Twas a charming, totally disarming evening at this naughty club, Baghdad.
Golf's a menace, I just can't do the Australian crawl. And I'm no better at volleyball. Ain't there anyone here for love? Sweet love, ain't there anyone here for love? Ballet athletic and non-athletic, can't keep up in a marathon. I need some shoulder to lean upon and a couple of arms to hold on. Ain't there anyone here for love? I'm not in condition to wrestle. I've never trained at a gym. Show me a man who can nestle, and I'll pin a medal on him. Need some chappy to make me happy, and you don't have to be Hercules. Don't anyone know about birds and bees? Ain't there anyone here for love? Sweet love, ain't there anyone here for love? Doubles, anyone? Two out of three, anyone? Oh. Cards free.
fossils and red corpuscles. I like a beautiful hunk of man, but I'm no physical culture fan. Ain't there anyone here for love? Sweet love, ain't there anyone? Light the candles, get the ice out, blow the bugle, it's today. Though it may not be anyone's birthday, and though it's far from I know that this very minute has history and we're here. And we'll give life quite a time more. And we'll live life all the way. All the time's up. Raise a racket. Pull the stars.
Wonderful friends. They have put their time, their energy, and their talents into this show. But more than that, they have put their hearts into it. And because of that, they have earned my deepest respect, admiration, and love. Thank you.
Thank you.
Normally, we don't normally single out individual people in this wonderful cast to thank because they are all so great. But after tonight, we all go back to our normal lives and our normal jobs. And I want to thank two people, actually, my boss and my dear friend, Edwina Ballerina. And of all time, Gail Wilson. Gail, that's your cue. That's your cue. How's that? How's that for a cue?
Now they tell me that's my cue. Okay.
I never will forget Jeanette McDonald. Just to think of her, it gives my heart a pang. I never will forget how that brave Jeanette just stood there in the ruins and
San Francisco, open your golden gates. You'll let the stranger wait outside the door. San Francisco, here is the wandering one. They are wander no more. Best, tell me you're the heart of all the golden west. San Francisco, I'm coming home again. I'm coming home again. Never to roam again.
The only